One day, as the villagers toiled in their fields, the boy climbed a small hill overlooking the village. With a mischievous grin, he bellowed, "Wolf! Wolf! The wolf is attacking the sheep!" Startled by the urgency in his voice, the villagers dropped their tools and rushed to the boy's aid. However, upon reaching the scene, they discovered there was no wolf, only the echoes of the boy's laughter. Amused by the villagers' gullibility, the boy decided to repeat the prank the next day. Once again, he stood atop the hill and shouted, "Wolf! Wolf!" The villagers, remembering the previous false alarm, hesitated but eventually rushed to the scene. To their dismay, there was no wolf, only the boy's laughter echoing through the hills. Days turned into weeks, and the boy continued his deceptive charade, relishing in the villagers' reactions. However, his repeated false alarms heightened the villagers' skepticism. Whispers of doubt circulated among them, eroding the trust that once defined their close-knit community. Unbeknownst to the boy, his actions would have consequences beyond his control. One fateful day, a real threat emerged as a hungry wolf descended upon the flock. The boy, recognizing the danger, frantically cried out, "Wolf! Wolf!" This time, however, his pleas fell on skeptical ears. The villagers, tired of his deceit, chose not to believe him. As the wolf savagely attacked the sheep, the boy witnessed the devastating consequences of his lies. The once playful pranks had eroded the trust the villagers placed in him. The aftermath was a scene of chaos and devastation, the once thriving flock now scattered and wounded. The village, too, was left to grapple with the fallout of their collective skepticism. The bonds of trust that once defined their community had been eroded, replaced by a lingering sense of doubt and suspicion. The very fabric of their interconnected lives had been torn, and the consequences of the boy's deception rippled through the once unified village. In the hushed conversations that followed, an unspoken understanding emerged, a realization that the village's collective strength lay in their ability to trust one another. The boy, through his misguided pranks, had unwittingly exposed the fragility of that trust. The moral of the story resonated through the hills and valleys, leaving an indelible mark on the collective consciousness of the village: nobody believes a liar, even when he is telling the truth. The boy, having learned a harsh lesson about the gravity of honesty, bore the weight of that truth as a constant reminder of the importance of credibility and the profound impact of deceit on a community bound by shared responsibilities. In the days that followed, the village worked together to rebuild not only their flock but also the trust that had been shattered. They recognized the necessity of forgiveness and redemption, understanding that the road to rebuilding trust was a challenging journey, one that required sincerity, transparency, and a commitment to the well-being of the community as a whole. And so, with the echoes of the wolf's howl still lingering in the night air, the village embarked on a journey of healing and restoration, determined to cultivate a culture of trust that would endure for generations to come. The boy, having matured through the crucible of consequences, became an unexpected catalyst for change, his story serving as a cautionary tale etched into the fabric of the village's history, a history marked by both folly and resilience.